See, we really like Kyla Kenedy because we like the fact that she's authentically 14 and you are psyched to drive.
So excited.
Okay.
My mom, not so much.
Your mom,
but
not so
I'm
much.
Ready. Yeah.
But here's the thing. In your native South Carolina, you get a learner's permit at 15. Here, you got to wait till 15 and a half.
Yeah.
And you can't wait.
I know. I can't wait. I'm so excited. I just want to, like, steal a car. And just...
Where's the... Oh, wow.
I know. I shouldn't do that, though.
It's a crime spree.
Kyla, calm down. Honestly. We're going to talk about Speechless in a second. You moved to Atlanta. And there's tons of work in Atlanta. Now, here all of a sudden, you're on The Walking Dead.
Yes.
And is it grim or fun, or what was it like?
Such a fun set. You know, I didn't know anything about it. I'd never seen it before. And I got a call. They don't tell you what it's for. You just get a script. And I did it. And then I Skyped, actually, with, you know, Galen Hurd and Scott Gimple. And I just loved them. They were amazing. And the set is not scary at all. You know, you're like, you see the walkers, and you're so afraid. And then you, like, eat lunch with them. And they're talking about their kids and their
pets. And I hear they're in makeup, and they look crazy.
Yeah, they always look so crazy. Yeah. My first day on set, I walked into the walker trailer instead of hair and makeup, and I was like, sorry, whoops.
Oh, whoops.
And the guy's like getting his face peeled off.
And did it ever mess up your sleep or anything? Did it ever affect you in any?
You know, it didn't. I thought for sure I would be afraid because I'm kind of a wimp when it comes to things like that. But they were just super nice. Like one guy, his name is Bob, and he was like showing me a picture of a hamster he had. It was really fun. It was like a good little set.
Bob seems like a nice guy.
Then Bob and his hamster.
Then you come out here, and Speechless is really, really good.
Yeah.
And you must enjoy it. And there's like other kids to be on the show with.
Yeah, it's really fun. You know, I get to work with so many amazing, talented actors, and I've been learning so much.
Minnie Driver, I like her on the show because she's very, like, bold and outspoken.
Yes.
Is she a fun TV mom?
Oh, she's amazing. She actually threw my 14th birthday party for me.
You're kidding.
Oh. Yeah, she's so amazing.
We both
love animals. Like, I'm obsessed. I'll take any animal you give me.
Okay.
And we just kind of connected. So it was she had a bunch of animals at her house. We had, like, all these Afro chickens and a pig. It was so much fun, yeah.
All right, birthday cake or cupcakes?
I gotta say birthday cake.
Okay, you're right.
Because you know, a cupcake, you finish it and you're like, I guess I can't have a second one. And a cake, you're like, I'll eat the whole thing.
You are so wise for being just 14.
Honestly,
you're right.
You're the smartest person we've ever had on the show. Here's a clip from Speechless. Watch this.
JJ was telling us about some new moves he learned this summer. You know how you could sit up unsupported for 10 seconds, then he'd fall over?
Yeah. Now I can sit for 20 SE seconds. Then fall over. Oh, I gotta see this.
You can't pick him up, can you?
What?
Muscle memory, man. Lifting a person, it's a very specific movement.
I'll get it back.
Wait, no, don't practice on JJ. You're gonna drop him.
Practice on something that doesn't matter.
I don't even care.
You can see where that joke was going. The actor who plays your brother, who has cerebral palsy, was that, adjustment is the wrong word, but was that different than working opposite other actors, or very similar to?
Yeah, you know, part of what drew me to the show was, you know, how inclusive it was and how we're making a statement. I feel like most shows actually that depict children with special needs, they don't actually cast anyone with special needs.
Right.
And so, you know, meeting Micah, he's so amazing and such fun to work with, so talented, and you know, just getting to connect with him. And you realize, you know, we're all the same. Everybody faces challenges. Mm-hmm. Everything's different. You just got to treat everyone with love and respect.
Oh, that is well said. I tell you what, but you are this, like, active kid.
Yes.
One thing about a show like that, which is shot on film, generally as a process, mm-hmm. it's hurry up and wait.
Yes.
Don't you just go nuts?
I have school. It's a weird thing that kids do, I guess. And so when we wait, I have to go to school. So I'm always busy,
always
working
something.
On things. But when we do sit, you know, it is kind of nice actually for me to just take a breath and just breathe.
Chill out.
Yeah.
What's your favorite subject at school?
Oh, let's see. Weird thing. I've been getting into math this year. Because I'm taking Algebra 1, and it's nice because I feel like with English, I'm all over the place. I'm like, what if my teacher doesn't like it? What if it's not good? And with math, it's like one right answer. I got it. And there's no way I can mess this up.
All right, so 14 is too early to ask. Do you think you want to continue and pursue this, or are there other jobs that might be fun?
Oh, of course. I'm very indecisive. I want to do everything. So,
right.
Like, one day I would want to be a policewoman, the next day I want to be a therapist. So I think that acting is definitely something that I'm going to be with doing forever.
All right. Well, I want you as a therapist. Premiere tonight. Why not?
Yeah,
Speechless, 8:30 on Channel 7 on ABC. Really nice to meet
Thank
you.
Kyla, you're the
one.
Thank you, guys.
Still ahead this morning, ghosts and goblins have taken over the Queen Mary.
KTLA's Christina Pascucci is in Long Beach. Good morning, everyone. Coming to you from the Queen Mary in Long Beach. We talked about this, Captain. We are previewing Doc Harbor, which launches tomorrow. Very exciting stuff, scarier than ever. We're going to tell you how you can see it, how to get tickets when your KTLA 5 Morning News comes back.
Oh, he is creepy. Then make sure you don't fall for it. The new phishing scam that is targeting Netflix users.